My name's David Tastad, and we're at UC Santa Cruz, California, and I'm in the Chen Lab, and we do developmental neuroscience. It's basically trying to understand how the brain and the nervous system develops from, like, essentially conception, and that has big implications because of the fact that if something minor goes wrong in that process, it can lead to multiple different types of diseases, including autism spectrum disorders, Alzheimer's, down the road. Our ultimate goals will be to get a better understanding of how the brain functions, and that stems down to the real molecular and cellular level. And if we can understand this as a whole, then we'll have a better understanding of how to fix these neurological disorders. I'm from San Diego originally, and I came up to Santa Cruz for my undergraduate. Loved it here, decided to go to graduate school here. I love mountain biking and going to the beach and going on hikes. Yeah, the atmosphere around here is great. You can look out almost any window and see just like redwoods and big Douglas firs. It's awesome. I've always wanted to help people, and I kind of just stuck with my strengths because I don't know, I've never been a good English, like, I couldn't read or write, like, exceptionally well, but my strengths have always been in the scientific field. Yeah, we'll take images on these really nice, expensive microscopes, running from, you know, $100,000 to a couple hundred thousand. And so we take these really high-quality images, and we try to look at neurons and how they project their axons and dendrites. And so from there, we can take the analysis of multiple neurons and try to quantify those with different statistical analysis and try to get a feel for how spaced out the neurons are, where they project their axons. Yeah, we do some quantitative analysis on the computer, and we'll also look at it and do counts with clickers and kind of get a feel for different types of neurons and their abundance and relativity to each other. And so that requires a lot of time sitting in front of a screen, looking at these cool glowing cells, and that kind of just allows us to understand how these are actually working. That's one thing I love about the lab environment. There's so many people all around, and you're constantly communicating, constantly interacting with others. It's not like you sit at a desk and you're secluded the whole time. You actually get to interact and have nice communications with others. It's great. I'd say just keep working hard, and if things don't always go the way that you want them to, just keep trying. And you don't have to have perfect grades, you don't have to be a perfect student, but if you stay interested and you stay motivated, things will work out.